Hi guys, it's Toddy here with Rekumbu, and this is the newly unveiled Huawei P9 Plus. This is one of two phones that Huawei has just unveiled here in central London, the new flagships for 2016, the P9 and the P9 Plus. As the name suggests, this is the larger of the two devices. It packs a 5.5-inch full HD display, and unlike the regular P9, it also features press touch, the same kind of 3D touch iPhone style technology that we've seen from previous Huawei devices. So as you can see, I can push harder on some of these app icons, and when the notification doesn't pop up, you actually have access to quick settings, basically. And Huawei says that at launch, this phone will have 18 different apps that support press touch. No word on whether they've rigged in any third-party developers or released any APIs, but chances are they are trying to get press touch onto more apps from more mainstream developers, just as 3D touch is on iOS. Now, the device itself is a pretty impressive piece of kit. On the inside, it's using the company's own Kirin 955 SoC, which is an octa-core processor. It's a 2.5, 1.8 gigahertz, like a dual quad-core arrangement, I believe, with 4 gigabytes of RAM. So the Plus is a little bit more powerful than the regular P9, which is 3 gigs of RAM, but they have the same processor. And we already saw the 950 in the Mate 8, and that was already an absolute blazing chipset. So this should be even faster. Swiping around, you can see that it looks pretty responsive. I know that's a very, very subtle test of performance, but you know, just on first impressions, this thing doesn't lag, and it shouldn't do. They're claiming that it's going to be, you know, as premium and slick as the likes of the iPhone 6s and the Samsung Galaxy S7, and that is indeed the key rivals that they've set their sights on here. So as well as this full HD display, if I take you around the rest of the body, we have this brushed hairline finish, which it looks like brushed metal, but it feels like plastic because it's basically very, very finely polished. So even though it has the visual effect, it feels like it's protected. It still feels metal, really rigid and solid, but it has this kind of strange, doesn't feel like metal on the finger, but it looks good. It looks really nice, in fact. And the big hook here is actually with this black bar at the top. So similarly to the Nexus 6P, which is made by Huawei, the P9 actually features a camera arrangement up the top. As you might be able to make out, there's actually two cameras, and there's Leica's name. Leica, who are known for making very expensive, very good dedicated camera systems. They've actually lent their talents to the P9 and the P9 Plus here. So the reason for dual cameras is it doesn't give you 3D imaging. It's not quite like the new G5 with its wide-angle lens. It's for depth perception. So this has a laser autofocus for nearby subjects for quick depth perception, but you can also get further away with these, just like your eyes, judging depth to distance. And it features a dedicated depth ISP, image signal processing unit, explicitly for depth. So that the idea is that you can get better looking shots with nice levels of bokeh, nice levels of image blur in the background, so you have a nice crisp foreground, so you just have more appealing photos to look at. Now, it's a 12 megapixel camera, and we also have, I believe it's an 8 megapixel front facer with a wide angle lens. No, it doesn't appear to have a front facing flash though, unlike some of the other phones, but we'll test that out come full review with the standard P9. Beyond that, the design, what's interesting is, as well as having that brushed hairline, have this body, it's a unibody design, it's got a battery tucked away inside of it, but it's thinner than the Samsung Galaxy S7, and I believe it's thinner than an iPhone 6s as well. And yet it doesn't have a camera bump. Because of that dual camera display, dual camera arrangement, they've been able to actually slim down the camera somehow, so it's perfectly flush. It's really nice in the hand. Know that when you put it down on the table, it's not going to rock. If this one didn't have this on the back, this wouldn't rock on the table, which is nice. The fingerprint sensor on the back is a new fingerprint sensor. It's Huawei's level 4 fingerprint sensor, which basically means that it can also detect the depth of the ridges in your fingerprint as well, which apparently means it's going to be faster and more secure when it's detecting your print. Do we have gestures? We also have swipe gestures, so you can swipe on the fingerprint sensor and pull down the notifications panel and things like that, etc. So there's a lot going on here. This is running Android 6.0 Marshmallow, of course, with the Emotion UI 4.1, which is the latest build of the company's own Android build. That means you don't get an app store. There's lots of dedicated widgets, and it also is what facilitates, excuse me, the press touch functionality there as well. Beyond that, the thing to remember is on the inside, you also have a 3,400 mAh battery, which Huawei says will last a day and a half of intensive use. Now, I stress the word intensive. They actually say you're going to get 2 days of standard use if you're a more lightweight user, but if you're a heavy user, you should get a day and a half of this, and it packs fast charging via Type-C USB at the bottom, which I can't show you because of the security security dock, but it is a Type-C connection, so it's got a reversible connection with fast charging built into the phone as well. So this is in fact coming to the UK. Unlike the P8 Max, which the company unveiled last year, we are actually going to be getting this larger phone. So this will be launching, expected around May 20th, 2016, with the 4 gigabytes of RAM model coming in. And I believe it's somewhere between £550 and £600. They quoted the Euros price, so UK pricing isn't absolutely finalised for this particular SKU. And with that, as I said, you get 64 gigabytes of internal storage, but the in typical Huawei fashion, the SIM tray can easily support dual SIMs, both on a 4G network, or one SIM card and one micro SD card, which the company says up to 1 terabyte, but I wouldn't be surprised if it actually accepts up to 2 terabytes, but that's just a guess. But they confirmed that it will accept up to 1 terabyte micro SD cards, which is pretty impressive stuff if you need a lot of media with you on the go. So that is a quick overview of the new Huawei P9 Plus here in London. If you have any questions about the smartphone, you can drop us a line down below in the comments, and you can stay tuned for a full review of its smaller sibling, the P9, soon on rockonroad.com/mobile. Thanks for watching.